In this video, we're going to use Gauss's law to compute the electric field around an infinite line of charge with a given linear charge density of lambda. Now remember, the linear charge density is measured in coulombs per meter, which means we can always get the charge for a given length of this line charge by taking the linear charge density and multiplying by the length. Now the first step in setting up a Gauss's law problem is to choose a Gaussian surface that shares the same symmetry as the charge distribution. And in this case, that's a cylinder. We set up a cylinder so that its symmetry axis lies directly along this line charge distribution. And that means every single point on the curved surface of the cylinder lies at exactly the same distance from our infinite line of charge. And our electric field over that curved surface is going to have a constant magnitude for every patch of area on the curved surface. And it's going to be perpendicular to every patch of area on the surface. In other words, parallel to the normal vector at every point. Now, one interesting point about this Gaussian surface is that we're going to have to compute the electric flux through this closed surface, but the only contributor to electric flux here happens through the curved part of the cylindrical surface. Along the endcaps, the electric field is going to be parallel to the surface, and because none of that electric field is penetrating the surface, it contributes zero flux across the endcaps. So we'll label things up a little before we apply Gauss's law. We're going to say the length of this cylinder is L and its radius is little r. So we start with Gauss's law. And that says the integral of E dot dA over the entire closed surface, in other words, the electric flux through the entire closed surface, is equal to the enclosed charge over epsilon zero, the permittivity of free space. And I'll post a link back to our detailed derivation of electric flux and Gauss's law if you'd like a reminder of where all that came from. So as we proceed with our electric flux integral, we're going to put in the fact that the end caps don't count. And I'm going to say that total electric flux through the closed cylinder is just equal to the electric flux through the curved part because the end caps are contributing nothing. Next, we use the fact that the electric field is parallel to the normal vector at every point along this surface. The direction of the normal vector is the direction of dA. So with the electric field parallel to that, the dot product becomes trivial. And now I just have the integral of E times dA, where E and dA are just magnitudes of those vectors. Next, we exploit the symmetry of our Gaussian surface again by saying that every single patch of area along this curved surface is at the same distance from our infinite line of charge, and therefore the electric field must have the same magnitude at every point. Because E is a constant, it can now be factored out of the integral, and I end up with E times the integral of dA, where I'm taking that area integral over only the curved part of the cylinder. So what's the area of the curved part of the cylinder? That's just the circumference times the length. So we end up with E times 2 pi r L. So Gauss's law says that that total electric flux is equal to the enclosed charge over epsilon zero. Now we need to find a way to express the enclosed charge inside this closed cylindrical Gaussian surface. And again, what we can do with our linear charge density is just multiply it by the length in order to get the total charge along that length that sits inside the cylinder. So the enclosed charge is lambda L. Now we can put everything together. Our flux integral turned out to be E times 2 pi r L. Our enclosed charge was lambda L, and we have an epsilon zero in the denominator. We can cancel an L from both sides and divide by 2 pi r, and we have our field magnitude at a distance of little r from our infinite line of charge. So E turns out to be lambda over 2 pi epsilon 0 times little r, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.